think it's important that, you know, when I initially conceive of a painting, I do have a story in mind, but I never map it out entirely. I try to keep it somewhat loose because I prefer for the viewer to observe and basically come up with their own story, you know. My work is very tactile, you know. There's a lot going on, there's a lot of layers. I mix a lot of things together that you're not supposed to. That's the process, that's what I do. I cut, I chop, I sew, I manipulate. Anything that's in my path is in danger of winding up in the painting. The process of how the rag got the state it's in is what's interesting. Whether it be people, places, things that interest me, you know, I always try and find particular subject matter. It could be political in nature, it could just be somebody that I admire, it could be a statement on pop culture, you know, something I read in the paper, something I see on the news. I'll tell my story, and it just evolves. A lot of art isolates a particular point in time, historically or emotionally. That process is very organic, you know. It's almost when you overthink a piece, that's when you get into trouble. And I think if you lay out the composition, the rest just explodes, man. In 1995, I wrote a screenplay entitled Bullet, which is loosely based on my childhood. And Mickey Rourke plays my older brother, Bart, and Adrian Brody plays me, Ruby, and my younger brother is played by Ted Levine. There's a sequence where Adrian Brody is suspended on this kind of homemade harness. And that was something that I did a lot when I was a kid. I would just, at 2 o'clock in the morning, I would scale down the side of the building and create some kind of a painting. I would find, you know, some crayons or chalk, just draw everything I could possibly get my hands on. Kind of like what Basquiat was doing, but 10 years before Basquiat, so go figure. Instead of Samo, I signed my name Mazel Tov. I used the symbol of Jewish star underneath, I wrote Mazel Tov. So I was pretty well known in my neighborhood, the out-of-control Jew that would deface public property. They were actually loading the dumpster with the doors, and I thought to myself how beautiful they were. And I could see that the quality of the door, the layers of paint was coming through. I started thinking about like a door, what a door represents, and how many people have come and gone through these doors, how many stories each door could tell if they could talk. I was so blown away by his use of found objects, but more importantly, how he created these stories from shit, you know what I mean? Crap, and made them so fantastically beautiful. trash and all run over and they think I'm insane, you know, I'll flip the trash can open and, you know, literally dive inside and pull out an old rusted can or a bottle or, again, I see, you know, such intrinsic beauty in the most simple, everyday household objects. I've always been so drawn to earth tones, you know, like the color of the leaf and the earth and the rust. The greatest compliment is that it looks like my work was dug out of the ground 200 years ago. It's just a projection of who I am, so it really reflects who I am as a being. My role is to just create it. People ask me a lot of times, like, when did you know you're an artist? Which, you know, I mean, I knew I was an artist from day one.